Good morning, YouTube. Happy Easter and welcome back to You Get What You Pay For with Robert M. Brown. Hey man, I'm a working guy. I love knives and I know it's early and I know it's Easter, but I wanted to show you some value and you get what you pay for on some large fixed blade knives. Right there in front of you, you are looking at three knives, three different price points. I really don't have kind of the in between this one and this one, but as far as price points, this one right here, $60 Amazon. This one right here, $80. Discontinued a long time ago. You can get it anywhere. And this one right here, I think I paid $350 for it, and it's discontinued. I just looked it up. It is listed for $499. So anyway, it appreciated. So let's get on with the video and compare these babies. Let's go low to high. All right, so first one we have is this one, which is, it says Perkins. PerkinsKnives.com right there. And this right here, I'll tell you about it before I open it up. It is, there's no model name. It is the blade material here says alloy steel, and it says ball bearing steel, which is a full tang knife, and it's a 58 to 59 HRC. It's got a Paca wood handle. Overall length is 12 inches with this actually very, very nice leather sheath. I mean, the sheath is really quite nice. And so this one here, let me open it up and show you what the blade looks like. Whoa, yeah, that's not a knife. There you go. That's quite a shiny knife. So first impressions is it's very glitzy. Glitzy, glamorous. I don't know. Everything a Bowie knife really shouldn't have. It's a clip point Bowie design. It's got this brass bolster, brass pins in the Paca wood handle. It definitely is full tang, and it's a substantial blade width. It did not say the blade width there. Let's just check it out. Blade width actually is, we're going to do it in millimeters. It's 4 millimeters, not 5. So I'm going to do this fast so you guys don't run away on me. This is, I chopped a couple things with it. It's been sitting in the sheath for a long time, and the blade has shown some signs of rust here and there, just sitting in the sheath. I did have some oil on it. But anyway, that's what you get for $59.99 from Amazon, and it's seems to be pretty good. I mean, it'd be good in a pinch. Next, we are going to move on to, and put this away so I don't cut myself. Next, we are going to do the SOG. This is the Jungle Warrior. Retailed for, there it is, $80. And you can put a sharpening stone in here or something in the sheath. It's got a pocket. The sheath is just kind of cheesy, but does the job. So the knife itself there, that's what it looks like. You know, I do use this knife a lot. I chop some firewood. I do some batoning with it. I actually throw it. So I throw knives and axes, and this is one of my favorite throwers. But It definitely did not stay straight. First time I threw it, the vibration alone when it hit the tree, wow, wow, it actually bent the tip. It was very, very strange because it went in straight, but it bent. But I just bent it right back. So that's an $80 knife, and I'll go over some specs with you. This one here is blade length is 10 inches, overall length is 15.5. This is an 8CR13 MOV steel blade, and it is full tank, goes all the way to the back there. It is a Kraton handle. And it's 19.4 ounces. It's a good chopper. I mean, it could be heavier, actually, I think. So it does have a lifetime guarantee because it's a SOG. So that is a great value for $80. The handle is very, very comfortable, and when you do wail on wood, the vibrations are dampened heavily by that handle. So let's move on to the last, the nicest one in my collection over the years. So let's get this one out of the way. And grand finale is this baby. This is Cold Steel Trailmaster VG1 Sanmai. This is the made in Japan older version. So let me just pop this baby up for you. All right, so there you go. You can see it. Now, I have chopped stuff with this, and it just doesn't scratch the blade. There's like some marks, tiny marks up there. I mean, you could barely see them. You can see that I've used it. And you can also see in there the sandwiched Sanmai method of hard and soft metals. Now, this knife right here, I'm going to tell you, is amazing. I feel like I could take on a bear with it. No. Anyway, I feel like it would last me a lifetime. There's lots of videos on this. Cold Steel hung a car engine from it by chains and shook it up and down to try to break the knife in half, which they failed at doing, I believe. So this one here, 18 ounces, 5/16 blade thickness. Blade length is 9.5 inches. The steel is the VG1 Sanmai 3. It's got a Krayex handle. The overall length is 14 5/8 inches. It comes with that Secure X sheath and it's a clip point. That's the Bowie style. It's not really, Bowie didn't carry a clip point into his battle that everybody knows about. It wasn't a clip point. But anyway, that's another story. So this one, yeah. Discontinued, very expensive, will last a lifetime, and boy, you get what you pay for. I'm telling you, the handle feels amazing. The knife feels like I could literally go out and chop down a 8-inch to 10-inch tree fast, like an axe. And maybe I'll do a video on me doing that just to show you how well this thing chops. So I'm gonna run away now. It's Easter. I'm gonna go wake some people up with some coffee and bagels. Please like and subscribe. Have a great day. And look forward to more videos because I love doing this. Peace.